Charity fundraisers are relentless in their pursuit of the wealthy. They pounce on the Sunday Times rich list the minute it drops through their letterboxes and spend a long time trying to find the most tenuous of links between the interests of each name featured with the concerns of their own individual charities. Their acquisitive antennae are finely tuned to detect any weaknesses in their wealthy prey. For example, the average charity fundraiser would reckon that a well-endowed widow of mature years must, by definition, be a soft touch. But that would be an average charity fundraiser who hadn't met Mrs. Pargeter. She was, however, always open to their approaches. She had no illusions that whatever inducements their invitations to events might contain, all they really wanted was her money. So if a charity towards whose aim she felt sympathetic asked her to attend a reception or theatrical performance or sporting fixture, she might well accept to check out what kind of setup it was. The one thing she drew the line at was charity balls. This was partly because of her single status. The late Mr. Pargeter had been a surprisingly neat and nimble dancer, so a ball in his company could be most enjoyable. But attending on her own, submitting to having her toes trodden on by a variety of unfamiliar partners with no sense of rhythm, was not Mrs. Pargeter's idea of fun. Also, charity balls always went on far too long. Though Mrs. Pargeter had a wide and fascinating circle of friends, few of them were the type who would ever want to get up a table for such an event. And in her experience, the kind of people who did want to get up a table had limited charm and limited conversation. So the thought of sitting on the same table with them at a charity ball from 7:30 till carriages at midnight, not to mention enduring indifferent food, sweet fizzy wine that wasn't champagne, the inevitable auction and endless speeches of thanks, held little attraction. In fact, on more than one occasion, Mrs. Pargeter had willingly paid the price of two tickets for the undoubted privilege of not attending a charity ball.